Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Tuesday, Memorial of St. John Chrysostom. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Those who are wise will shine brightly like the splendor of the firmament, and those who lead the many to justice shall be like the stars forever.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, who willed that the Bishop St. John Chrysostom should be illustrious by his wonderful eloquence and his experience of suffering, grant us, we pray, that instructed by his teachings, we may be strengthened through the example of his invincible patience. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, as the body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For in one spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one spirit. Now the body is not a single part, but many. Now you are Christ's body and individually parts of it. Some people God has designated in the church to be first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then mighty deeds, then gifts of healing, assistance, administration, and varieties of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all prophets? Are all teachers? Do all work mighty deeds? Do all have gifts of healing? Do all speak in tongues? Do all interpret? Strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful song.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Know that the Lord is God. He made us. We are his. We are his people, the flock he tends.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Enter his gates with thanksgiving, his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
For he is good, the Lord, whose kindness endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Alleluia, alleluia. A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus journeyed to a city called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd accompanied him. As he drew near to the gate of the city, a man who had died was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. A large crowd from the city was with her. When the Lord saw her, he was moved with pity for her and said to her, "Do not weep." He stepped forward and touched the coffin. At this, the bearers halted and he said, "Young man, I tell you, arise." The dead man sat up and began to speak, and Jesus gave him to his mother. Fear seized them all, and they glorified God, exclaiming, "A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people." This report about him spread through the whole of Judea and in all the surrounding region. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, this particular gospel, you know, according to several commentators, is one of the most moving gospel passages. No, and let me invite you to reflect on 3 points, you know, from this gospel passage. Number one is you realize that this particular situation represented probably the suffering of some of the most marginalized sectors of society. So that first point, no? And then the second point is how Christ was able to be moved by this particular scene, no? The compassion of Christ. And then the third point is how Christ acted on the situation. Those 3 points that I invite you to reflect on. Siguro itong 3 punto to, mahalaga na makita natin na pag tinignan mo yung detalye, dito mo makikita isa sa pinaka masasabi natin, ano, yagit, ano, sabi nga natin sa Pilipino, isa sa pinaka mga yagit na miyembro ng society, no? Or isa sa pinaka mga nasa laylayan ng lipunan, no? Yung unang punto na pagninilayan natin. At yung pangalawang punto ay yung compassion ng Panginoon, yung kanyang kakayahan pasukin ang sitwasyon at maging mapukaw yung kanyang awa o pagmamahal do sa mga tao. Compassion, no? Tapos yung 3rd punto ay yung pagkilos niya mula sa compassion na ito, no? First, about the suffering, no? The suffering of the human situation. When you take a look at this, you take a look at the woman, no? Number one, she was a widow. Remember, the widow was one of the poor of Yahweh, no, during the time of the Lord. And not only was she a widow, but now she loses her only son, no? So you realize it's almost like double whammy, as we would say, no? So here you have probably, you know, one of the most, you might say, marginalized, no? She represents one of the most marginalized sectors of society. Aside from being a widow, she loses whatever is left of her family. And I guess we are invited to, in the same way that the Lord immediately was able to see this, we're invited to keep our eyes open, no? Open to the human situation around us. I think that's very, very important, especially now, no? Especially now that as we are hoping to emerge from this pandemic, as we're hoping to rebuild, I think it is important that we become sensitive to the lives of people around us, no? Siguro yung unang punto na yan, ano? Makikita natin na yung babae sa ebanghelyo natin ngayong araw, no? Siya ay isang balo at isa rin siyang kaisa-isang anak niya itong namatay. Kaya kung titingnan mo, parang dalawang pagbigat sa kanya, no? Tandaan natin yung mga balo ang isa sa mga poor, the poor of Yahweh, no, sa banal na kasulatan, no. At tapos nawala pa yung kaisa-isa niyang anak. Siguro inaanyayahan tayo na maging bukas ang ating mga mata sa ating kapaligiran at sa dinaraanan ng marami natin mga kapwa Pilipino o mga kapwa tao natin, no. Dahil nga, no, panalangin natin na pag-unsad mula sa pandemya, sana ay maging bukas ang ating mga mata, no, sa lahat ng dinaanan ng ating mga kapwa. And then the second point is, of course, the compassion of Christ. Immediately, you realize how quick the Lord picks up the emotions of a particular moment. How the Lord is able to enter that particular moment, no, with His heart, with His spirit. No? And here you have the Lord immediately was able to feel the sorrow of the mother. No? And therefore, I think that is the second point that I want you to pray for. To ask for the grace, each and every one of us, to ask for the grace to have a little bit of Christ's compassion in us. I think if there is anything that we need to rebuild our nation, to rebuild our society, to rebuild our world, it is that sense of compassion. Especially compassion for those who are suffering, for those who need the grace and the love and the presence of God in their own lives, that we may become channels of these graces. But it begins with compassion. Siguro yung pangalawang punto na yon. Mahalaga na meron tayong kakayahan na makaugnay, ano, makipag-ugnayan sa mga taong nagdurusa. At yun nga ay sa pamamagitan ng, I don't want to use the word ano, habag, no? Or awa. Pero yung compassion, sorry, hindi ko pa, hanggang ngayon hindi ko makita yung tamang salita para sa compassion, no? Nandyan yung awa, nandyan yung habag. Pero hilingin natin na tayo ay makiisa, no, sa mga taong nagdurusa sa ating paligid, kagaya ng ating Panginoon. And then the third and final point is the ability of Christ to act coming from this compassion. And that is the miracle that we see. That is the miracle. Of course, some people would say, no, that the gift of Christ was able to analyze right away, no, that the boy was, that the young man was not dead, no. So anyway, that's for another reflection altogether. But just the ability to act, no, out of compassion and performs the miracle. And let me end with that. Remember, miracles in the Gospels, as I always said before, they do not prove the divinity of Christ. But the miracles show the compassion of God. And here clearly, the Lord shows the compassion of God. And that is the third and final point for our reflection. Tandaan natin ang mga milagro sa banal na kasulatan ay hindi pagpapatunay ng pagiging Diyos ng Panginoong Hesukristo, kundi ito ay pagpapakita ng pagmamahal at ang habag ng Diyos para sa atin. And today, let us pray that we may become also channels of God's miracles, that through our own little acts of kindness, little acts of goodness, people will be able to encounter the mercy and the love of God for them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. To show His divine compassion and authority, Jesus performed miracles. Filled with awe at these wonders, let us pray to the Father, Lord, hear our prayer.
That God's love and care may be shown to our people through the guidance and help of our church pastors, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the state may become a channel of God's compassionate love by the special attention and assistance they extend to the poor and the sick people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have recently suffered the loss of a loved one may, with God's help, recover their faith in life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us now remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together, let us offer our prayer for our nation. Panginoon ng kasaysayan, sa aming paghahanda para sa 125th anibersaryo ng pagsilang ng aming bansa, sabayan mo po kami sa aming proyekto na magtatag ng isang lipunang may tunay na kalayaan para sa lahat. Kalayaang nakaugat sa pagkalinga, hustisya at katotohanan, kalayaan mula sa kahirapan na nag-aalis mula sa nakararami ng pagkakataong mapabuti ang kanilang buhay. Kalayaan mula sa gutom, kawalan ng tirahan at kakulangan ng dekalidad ng mga simpleng serbisyo sa pangangalaga ng kalusugan at sa edukasyon. Kalayaan mula sa panlilinlang, kasinungalingan at manipulasyon. Kalayaan upang maging mga aktibo at positibong tagapagbuo ng aming bansa. Bigyan mo kami ng katatagan ng loob at inspirasyon na walang humpay na itaguyod ang isang bansang tunay na malaya para sa lahat ng mga Pilipino. Amen. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the sacrifice which we gladly present in commemoration of Saint John Chrysostom be pleasing to you, O God. For taught by him, we too give ourselves entirely to you in praise, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint John Chrysostom, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint John Chrysostom, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together, let us offer our prayer for an end to the pandemic and to rebuild our nation.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to ask for your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. Bless all those who help see us through the challenges the pandemic brought, those who tirelessly work to render genuine service, especially to those who suffer the most. Guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission and to end this pandemic. Heal all who are afflicted. Grant eternal rest to those who died and consolation to their loved ones. As we move forward, grant us the grace to see clearly, choose well, and act right in order to build a nation closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, faith, hope, compassion, and love. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Canusod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Grant, O merciful God, that these mysteries we have received as we commemorate St. John Chrysostom may confirm us in your love and enable us to be faithful in confessing your truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And together let us offer our prayer for peace and joy for our world. Father in heaven, we offer to you this prayer in the words of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We have so much to do and we must do it together. In the darkness of the conflicts we are living through, each of us can become a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. To us Christians, the future has a name and its name is hope. It is the virtue of the heart that does not lock itself up, does not dwell on the past, and not only survives the present but is able to see tomorrow. Bless our world, Father, with the peace and joy that the cross of Christ, the cross and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, won for us. For all those affected by calamities, natural and man-made, for all those who suffer from the structural injustices of our time, amen. Our Lady, Mother of God and Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat and have a good day ahead.
Hey! patuloy ninyong pagmamalasakit, pagbabahagi at pag-alay kapwa, may napakain tayong 1,757 individuals na nanggagaling sa 300 families from Luzon, Visayas at Mindanao. Ang pamilya program ay hindi lang po natin bubusugin ang tiyan ng ating mga tinutulungan, mga pamilya, kung hindi bubusugin din natin ang kanilang isip at puso. Dahil sa pamilya feeding program, ang mga kapamilya na tinutulungan natin ay lumalalim ang kanilang pananampalataya, pakipag-ugnayan sa kapwa at pagmamalasakit sa lipunan. Nang dahil sa inyo, ang mga kapwa natin ay nabusog, nabigyan ng pag-asa at may maliwanag na bukas. Through pamilya program, stomachs are fed, hearts are full, souls are nourished. Taos-puso kaming nagpapasalamat sa lahat ng mga kapamilya natin na nagmalasakit, nagbahagi, at nag-alay kapwa.